Here I'm going to describe the simplest cubic equation of state, which is the van der Waals equation, and then do a couple calculations to demonstrate how a real gas can really differ significantly from an ideal gas. So first, let's write down the van der Waals equation. And this relates pressure in terms of ideal gas constant, absolute temperature, the volume, and this is specific volume, volume per mole, minus a constant. This constant is positive. And then a second constant over, again, specific volume squared. So this is the van der Waals equation. Let me pause and label these terms. So I've labeled the terms R, of course, being the gas constant. So this constant B relates to the fact that molecules actually occupy space. So ideal gas law, we assume molecules occupy no space. We can compress a gas down as far as we'd like. But for a real gas, as we compress and get molecules close to each other, we can't get that volume close to zero. And so this term B is accounting for that fact. So as we try and compress in this term V minus B, as V gets close to B, that term, of course, becomes small, which means the pressure will end up being much higher than ideal gas pressure. The second term is related to the fact that there are attractive interactions between molecules. And so because A is positive, then the second term with the negative sign in front of it means the pressure, due to attractive forces, the pressure is going to be lower than what we expect from ideal gas law. These constants can be related to critical pressures and critical temperatures. So A can be written as ideal gas constant squared, the critical temperature, of course, absolute degrees like Kelvin, and the critical pressure, and the critical pressure and temperature are unique for each molecule. So the A terms may be different for a different molecule. And the B term, again, the gas constant, critical temperature over 8 times the critical pressure. So let's look at some simple calculations, and we'll do these for carbon dioxide. Critical pressure, 73.9 bar, and the critical temperature, 304.2 Kelvin. So I can calculate A and B, and let me just write those down. So now let's do a couple calculations, and we're going to pick a temperature of 275 Kelvin, and let's suppose the volume is 0.20, and I want to determine the pressure. So the pressure, if it were an ideal gas, I'm only going to report this 3 significant figures. So this is ideal gas. And now what's the pressure for the van der Waals equation state? Well, it's 54.1 bar. Dramatically different. And the pressure is lower because of attractive interactions and because this negative term here is what's most significant, correction, if you like, to ideal gas law. And so let me pause and just write that down. So let's look, again, we'll keep the temperature at 275, but let's look at a case where the volume is smaller. Now notice that this volume is starting to get close to this B value. So we're trying to push the molecules very close together. We probably don't really consider this a gas, but we can still apply the 9 ideal equation of state, this cubic equation, the van der Waals equation. Again, the pressure, if it were an ideal gas, 457 bar. Again, this is 3 significant figures. And the pressure, van der Waals equation, 1707 bar. Well, now notice we have the opposite situation. The real gas has a higher pressure than the ideal gas. And this is because now this first term is dominating. We have a specific volume close to the B value. So this denominator becomes very small. It takes very high pressure to push these molecules close together. Probably not something we really consider a gas. But the main point here is there are two contributions, attractive forces and repulsive forces, and which one dominates and how much different we are from ideal gas depends on what pressure and temperature conditions we're at.